see if we can figure this out. So I think to connect to a Variant ICS server, I just installed a Variant ICS server on my server. I think I need to have Winboard. So let's go get that. Okay. Run the installer. Yeah, Winboard. It connects to a Variant ICS, or connects to FICS or ICS kind of server. Copyrights, GNU GPL version 3. I already am pretty familiar with that. Let's see, can get all some fancy engines to go with that and get some chess variants. Sure, why not? Shogi, which is the reason I actually installed the server in the first place, but you know, it's cool. Yeah, that seems fine. Sure, that looks like an okay place to install it. Well, you'd be surprised. They've actually been maintaining this. I think it was in the last year they released Winboard 4. For the longest time, it's been Winboard 3 or something, and they've been just constantly building new stuff into it. So I should be able to find Winboard over here. Chess variant server. Now, I've heard from other people that that particular server at this IP address isn't up. So this is where I improvise a little bit. Let me just take one more look. Can we get this video and clip that awesome end game? Come on. Looks like the video's not available, guys. Somebody sometime's gonna have to clip what happened in that end game. All right, so Winboard. Don't want to uninstall. Just want to go to. Oops. Don't need that up. Close that. All right, so just going over to Winboard here. Where's the thing that allows you to specify the server to connect to? Startup dialog. There we go. I want to use an internet chess server, but not that one. I want to use my server. I don't know that I have TimeSeal installed, but you know, if we do, we'll use it. Okay. Sure. Okay, fine. Huh. Is it seriously rejecting my connections? That's disappointing. Come on. Why would it reject my attempts to connect? It worked when I tried to connect from other machines to the server. I'm sorry, from the server to itself. I'm getting things backwards there. Obviously, I've got the port open. Else, I wouldn't be getting all these messages. Gonna bounce the server. Big surprise there. Let's reload the server. Try that again. Winboard. Startup dialog. Pin. Sure, whatever. This should work. By the way, you're all welcome to try to connect to this too. It's out there and up and running and stuff. And well, okay. This is not the only site, by the way, that supports S-Chess. But man, that's a bummer. Guest. Now, why did that not take? I did test this yesterday and was able to connect from the server to itself. Maybe it doesn't work if I have TimeSeal running. Maybe I've got to connect not using time seal. Password. You can guess what that was. So, apparently I'm in. Sweet. Let's see. Okay, so. Yeah, apparently time seal's not working yet. There's no lag compensation, but yeah, anybody can log in. I didn't create S-Chess, but somebody created a chess server that plays all allows you to play variants, including Shogi. I think it supports S-Chess. We're really doing this on the fly because I just have not had the dedication to, I don't know, to not do it on the fly. So we're doing it live, guys. It's gonna be okay. Chat window, admin. Wait, my mouse is misbehaving here. I want to drag this if I may. So I got two chat windows. Apparently I'm my own partner or something. I don't know what's going on there with this interface, but C3O SC for CR1 chess. Nice. If anybody's ever been a Fix admin, let me know what commands to type in and I can create new accounts and stuff, but otherwise I guess people log in as guests. I guess since people are doing this as C3OSC unrated. C3O unrated SC. There we go. No, S chess is CR1 chess. And since I guess we're probably curious what CR1 chess is, it's a variant created by Grandmaster CR1 in 2007. Now he says, and I guess this article doesn't explain, that he created it with his friend Bruce Harper, and so it was a joint creation between them. It's played on your standard 8x8 board, but you got a couple new pieces, a hawk that can move like a knight and a bishop, and an elephant, which can move like a knight or a rook. And you're all familiar with the queen, which can move like a rook or a bishop. So these are the couple new pieces. They're obviously, well, CR1 himself has given some sort of demonstration. You can look it up on YouTube. He demonstrates that an elephant is a really difficult piece to deal with, and a hawk is quite a surprising piece to deal with. So when you move a piece off of your first rank, you can place one of these two pieces onto the first rank. Note that, like, if you m place an elephant and then you move the elephant, you can't place the hawk where the elephant used to be. It has to be one of the pieces that was originally on this first rank, and the first time you're moving it, you can put one of these extra pieces on the board. And okay, yeah, this article does say CR1 has expressed dissatisfaction with the name CR1 Chess, noting that the variant was a joint development with his friend Bruce Harper. And so they, I don't know to what extent this is actually true, that he's like strongly advocating for this name or some, I don't know. He's done, CR1 himself has done a lot to promote the variant, and I'm not sure to what extent Harper's helped with that. Whatever. Just putting some rules out there. Okay, it looks like somebody linked to the YouTube video where he gives this demonstration. And for all I know, Bruce Harper's done what he can to publicize the game along with CR1. It's not a big deal, but it's nice to give credit where credit's due. So that said, I wonder if I've lost on time yet. Apparently not. So yeah, If people feel so motivated, you can log into this, or you can be a guest on this server. It's in the stream title, you know where to find it. You'd need to go look for this webpage that's playing on the Variant ICS. You can find this pretty readily through Google. And get Winboard and hook up to the server, and we could play games there. If nobody's up for that, I guess I could try to find a different site to play it on. So I'll give this a minute. Yeah. I've been thinking for some time it could be fun to go ahead and play some of these games. And for a while I was thinking, gosh, what's it gonna take to get this into the Lee Chess server? I realized that actually it's pretty complicated to add that. Just there's a lot of details. And then it occurred to me, hey, wait, somebody already came up with a server that allegedly supports this game, and there's allegedly already a client that works with, so, you know, this is a way people can play the game. Hey, Zwish. Welcome. Yeah, I was actually, like, I've participated in every one of those threads where people have mentioned the variant. I've been just constantly bringing it up over and over and trying to be involved in those threads because I know some people follow and I'm just trying to popularize it in some way, even though it's going to be a huge headache and it's probably not going to get added to Lee Chess anytime soon. Yeah, I'm trying to subtly exert influence to make the world a better place there. But, you know, in the meantime, we've got this. And this isn't nothing, so. Let's see. How do I best do a capture of everything that's going on? Like, do I have to dismiss this window or minimize it or something to not distract? Have to minimize that. There we go. So yeah, now. Oh, this board is pretty small too. Let me fix some of this here. Let's put this over here. Get the board. For the longest time, I don't know if you were able to. Well, yeah, on the Linux version of this, on Xboard, resizing the board is a big pain. You've seen some of my previous streams where I did like engines versus engines, and getting things to size appropriately has just been a mess there. But yeah, here, this not a problem at all. Let's see. I see Nightbot's still there. Yeah, that server's still in development and stuff, but that's the wrong URL. You want the one that's in the stream title. Let's see, I think. So, let me see if I can, like. Wait, it's called Help Examine. Next. 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 Okay, how do I examine a CR1 chess game? I'm trying to remember. There is a way to examine a game that's not of a standard type. What was it? Does anybody remember? Also, let me check. Do I have my variables set? Do I have like a way to turn on the bell to let me know when people are doing stuff? Set bell one. Okay, bell on. We don't know if that works or not. Oh, I forgot I could do fun stuff here. Shout hi. Oh. What? Didn't do very much. Okay. But yeah, since I'm the admin, I can do things like shouting and server announcements and stuff, I guess. That's pretty awesome. Let's see. ICS. Do. Oh, we can do dual board. That could be fun. Okay. Got one click move in case you want to cheat. That's awesome. What else do we have here? We got mute all sounds, but where do we have the sounds so I can know if we got things turned on or not? We can swap the clocks if we want to put white on the right. Got our eval graph. Can type in moves. But where's the sound stuff? I want to just know if it's on. Obviously, it's not muted, but I don't know what sounds I've got enabled. We could put this always on top. Let's see. Always queen. Probably not a bad thing. Although promoting to other pieces in S chess could be fun. Could do blindfold just to make things exciting. Put the coordinates on. Sure, why not? Yeah, you can see these little coordinates. There's a little 6 there, a little H down here. But yeah, we're. Oh, here's the sounds. Yeah, how about that sound? What other sounds do we have? Got alarm.
Bow on time.
Hey, every time we make a move, we could have it play
Bow on
that.
time.
How great would that be? Could have it do that every time we move. Oh man. But is there a gong? Yes, there's a gong. Every move, we got the gong. That's pretty awesome, but let's see.
You win.
Every time we move. Yeah, I like that one. What else? That definitely does catch a per. Oh, here. Every time we move, have the move sound play. Oh, come on. There we go. And for a bell. Yeah, okay, that's fine. Shouts, no noises. Challenge. Oh, come on. You gotta play the challenge thing. Incoming challenge.
Challenge.
Oh, that's lame. I should go rip the one they have in Dasher. Oh, you can't message me on the server. Okay. Well, so if you're logged in on the server, you can do what I did here, which I think was seek 30 USC. And this just puts a 3-minute CR1 chess seek out there. That might actually be a bit fast. 50 unrated CR1 chess seek 10 unrated CR1 chess. So that's all out there. Right, but you should at least be able to accept these seeks out here. Either by typing in the same seek command and it automatically gets matched up. Oh, here we go. So I can type accept for sought. Oh no, that's not it. It's play for. Ah, what happened here? Some kind of fun happened. All right. Let's play Okay. Cool. Apparently I have to put the piece on the board first. So let's say, oh, never mind. Okay. Let's put the hawk here. There we go. So I have to click, and then move the piece. Now I've got a hawk defending my bishop. Spiffy. Suppose I probably don't need that. Or, oh, he did say hi. I should say hi back. Hi. Oh, you resigned. Bummer. You see my browser, you do not see a chessboard. Oh, I do apologize for that. Let's see. Wait, what's going. Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. Seek 10. Oh, unrated Sierra on chess. Oh, okay. Play 0. Nice. Knight f3, placing hawk on g1. Just for schnicks, let's place the elephant on b1. Oh, it's not working. Oh no. Did you. Okay, so I went here to this site. Let me try to manually type this into where my chat window's at. HTMNewBonti.net slash VICS. You need this version of Winboard. This thing. Winboard 4.5TM. It's the one that I used. You should still be able to type things in. Like, if you type in this particular notation, hopefully the server takes it. But. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, I should have paid attention. I didn't see the abort request. Alright, we're 2-0, guys. Got a 2-game lead. But yeah, you can go there and obtain the client, and hopefully it'll render things right. Oops, what happened there? Now, it's probably unwise of me to drop pieces so early in the game. I should probably be reserving a piece and or like not placing the elephant back here where it's difficult to get out. But yeah, I've heard that sacrifices in this game could be pretty exciting. Also, if anybody remembers, like, what are all the admin commands, that'd be great. Could start making accounts and stuff. I know A help lists some stuff. Like I've got A set pass WD. Got A set handle, A set admin, all the fun toys. So, yeah, if anybody can help me remember how to do any of that, I could create new accounts on here. Anybody who previously had an account on this particular server, sorry, I re-imaged this server. I was having, well, I upgraded it, and in so upgrading, I was having great difficulties getting it working, and so I re-imaged it numerous times until I finally fixed all the bugs, and as far as I know. So I think I could say like set gin1, which shows me game res. Okay, what is it? Set pin1 that shows. Yeah, okay, now I can see when people log in and log out. Did I implement it? No, this. I just took the server, which wasn't completely working, and got it up to a state where it's able to run and hopefully not crash. I did not author this Winboard client. This Winboard client. I was expecting this about dialogue to say who did it. This is not exactly what I expected to see here, but that's okay. But yeah, I didn't make this. I guess it's Alessandro Scotti, or however you say that. Alex Scotti did this. Presumably with numerous other developers, including H.G. Mueller, who also hosted the server code. I just took that existing server code, got it working on my machine, and downloaded the client. You saw, if you were here the first couple minutes of the stream, you saw us trying to piece that all together. Obviously, I didn't make that client that I downloaded from some third-party site. No, actually, apparently TimeSeal's not working on my server. So no, that's not required. At some point, I'll figure out how to install TimeSeal on my server. So let's see. Oh, he logged out. Bummer. Match guest 5-5 unrated Sirwan chess. I honestly don't know what Lee Chess holds in the future. I really don't know. I know it would be a large undertaking to make CR1 chess happen on that server, for all the reasons that have been enumerated in the forums, and for an additional reason that, hey, look, we've got a server that can play it. So why bother making a second server that can play it? But yeah, I don't know. If it gains in popularity, maybe they'll do it. Who knows? I can't commit anything for them. And besides, I don't know. We've got working server here. If I ever find the free time, I mean, I've got numerous other chess-related stuff ongoing at the moment, including trying to get endgame tables for variants working, including trying to support all the new developments that are being done, trying to just help code review and make sure we don't do something silly with getting more anti-chess working. So between all that and between other things, and the other games I just play on my stream, I have not. It's ambiguous. There we go. Put some challenges out there. But yeah, if I ever find the time, maybe even. I mean, the prime place to put this kind of extension would seem to be, believe it or not, the Relay Chess server. Can you imagine Relay CR1 Chess? It would be a complete headache. It would be hilarious. People would cry. But no, just relay chess and the whole idea of CR1 chess have some things in common. The idea of having pieces that are able to move multiple ways, just, yeah. I'm not committing to that being done anytime soon because, from a coding perspective, that's quite a headache. And I mean, we just need to get. I need to find more time to do the whole relay chess stuff too. I've been slacking on that. That's my fault. But hey, we've got a CR1 chess server. But yeah, how completely nuts would that be? Yeah, we definitely could. I think, honestly, it could be possible to do it both ways as its own variant and possibly as some kind of weird hybrid variant that would completely freak people out and probably be way too much for people to absorb. We're sacking. We're definitely sacking, guys. What's the best way to win this? He says, not even stopping to pause and think that this might not be winning. Okay, we're gonna take here. Right, but goodness. I mean, if I had time to play D5, this could be crushing. Sacrifices get out of control very quickly in this variant. Yeah, no pressure. And plus, we've got this, and this is great. I want to win this. I want to make some brilliant sacrifice that just wins us on the spot. It's not happening, is it? How do I get my pieces out quickly? Okay, we're gonna go with this, even though I'm not really sure where it's going. Oh, I forgot to put a piece down here. Not that that matters necessarily. I was more thinking of putting my pieces on G8 than on D8. Trying to use the provided version of Winboard. Okay. Yeah, what I discovered is you have to click the thing and then put it onto the back rank before moving your piece. I have not yet exercised that capability this game. But I could have, in theory, placed a piece on D8 before moving my queen. This isn't like Crazy House where you can just drop it anywhere. In this variant, you do have to drop it onto an occupied square on the first or eighth rank, and then move that piece. I appear to have caused myself quite a headache. Wait, I cannot play knight takes h2. That would be ridiculous. Okay. So my next move, I'm gonna remember to put something on g8. Or am I? Am I just gonna move the knight and then castle and place something on e8? Yeah, well, the issue there is that you have to You have to move the piece. You have to drop the piece and then move the piece. In fact, I did raise that usability concern earlier. And it was explained to me that you have to place the piece first, otherwise, it would be ambiguous when your turn's over. Okay. So, here I'm going to place my elephant. And wait. Click, 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 drag. There we go. So that's how it's supposed to work. Not that I'm playing this well, but at least that's how legal moves function. I can't even play Queen A. Oh my goodness. Well, this is not going well, guys. The home team is not winning this game. And I sacked a piece to get this, didn't I? Oh dear. Okay. Looks like I'm gonna end up sacking more stuff pretty soon. Let's put the queen over here. Just for the sake of getting something for the night, we're gonna do this. No, I'm. You see, I've already lost a bishop. The fact that I've got all these other pieces on the board doesn't compensate for the fact that he's still got a bishop pair, and I have no bishops. So, I am still down material. This is honestly pretty terrible. My only consolation is that maybe he'll forget to place these pieces, and so I won't be completely down. Okay, so yeah, now things are starting to show. So that's the elephant. It can move like a knight or like a rook. Let's see. Unfortunately, my elephant's not very well placed. Okay. Yeah, the hawk drop on c1 could have been a lot more epic. But he might be setting up for something, you never know. Okay, well, that's a sign that I should probably be moving this, right? There aren't any very many good places to move it. Let's try this space. I never claimed to be good at this. So this is my big master plan here. I'm gonna place a piece and move a piece. Brilliant, I know. Shocking. Okay. In all honesty, my hawk should probably be over here. My elephant should probably be over here. That's my first game. You can't blame me for messing it up this badly. Okay. So that's pinned. Let's step out of the pin. Step into a different pin. Is there anyone who has ever played a game of this? If I had to guess, Sierra One's probably played a game of Sierra One Chess. As for us, I don't think any of us has any idea what they're doing. Although I'm losing this, I'm down by two bishops or something. Actually, just down one piece and a couple pawns, and all my pieces are on the wrong squares. And my king's under attack. But other than that, I'm doing pretty good. Okay. Let's just make some innocent do-nothing move here. See if he's paying attention. Oh, wait. Okay. That's actually more complicated than I thought it was. Yeah. This might not be going so well. Oh, okay. I'm not dead in the way I thought I was, but I might be dead in a different way. Hold the phone. I might be okay. Jeez. I'm trying to calculate stuff, and I'm not familiar with the new pieces. Not as familiar as I'd like to be. I think this might be bearable. Oh, hang on. There is one thing slightly in my favor here, and that's that he's moved every piece on his back rank at least once. And once you've already moved a piece, you can't place a piece onto that square anymore. So, by virtue of the rules, I'm now equal in material, I think. Yeah, so we got the hawk, which moves like a bishop or a knight. We've got the elephant, which moves like a rook or a knight. And then we've got the queen, which moves like a rook or a bishop. I might have to move faster. Thankfully, I put an increment on this game, or this could get kind of ugly. Oh, are you serious? Wow, that's horrible. Jeez. Okay. Well, damn. Fine. I'm kind of screwed now for multiple reasons. Oh. Well, yeah, there's that too. I might not be winning this. Yeah, he goes for the rook. I probably would too. Only because I miss the fact that, like, he could just trade queens. And have a fun end game. Okay. Good, we get to see how all the pieces move this game. Okay. Guess we're going here. Maybe I should turn off that Bing every time piece moves thing. You missed two mates in one. That's okay. Still got a game going here. Let's go pawn go. Okay. Oh, I got mated. Bummer. GG. Let's turn off that bing noise. Let's see. Sounds, move, no sound.
Challenge.
Oh, cool. Let's see, this was. What's the time control? 10-2. Okay, 10-2. yeah. We're gonna go play to cramp black on this one. We're gonna go full four pawns attack. Gosh darn it. Let's turn off the sounds since apparently changing the sound set didn't work. Let's try changing this one more time. Sounds, move, no sound. Defaults, sure. Okay. It's still binging. Let's mute all sounds. Let's see if it still bings at us. Okay. We might be trapping a knight here. There we go. Oh, right. I have to do like set bell zero. I'll try unmuting that once more. There we go. Yeah, having bell on apparently was not the way to enjoy the server. Okay, we've got an elephant on the board. Take one of those. Okay, I could put the hawk in the corner. Man, if I could break the center open, that'd be great. Okay, so he's kind of boxed his king in. Let's see if we can do anything to take advantage of that. Yeah, that bell noise does sound like the Windows error sound. So this moves like a knight or like a bishop, but it does not move like a rook. So if I really wanted to, I could take d5. He takes back. Oh, hang on, I forgot. This moves like a knight. This gives me some interesting possibilities, doesn't it? So now I got this awesome. Bummer. But yeah, I got this awesome shot against that square. Okay, take one of those. See. Do I really want to play knight d2? I don't want to take time out for that. On the other hand, I don't want to see a knight on c4. Wow. I have a choice between knight g5. Well, he's already placed all his pieces, so I don't have to think about that sort of consideration. But, knight g5 or the cowardly knight d2. Yeah, can't do the cowardly thing on stream. Okay. Let's see, do I do bishop takes? I think so, because otherwise my bishop's kind of out of business. Let's see, this moves like a knight or a bishop, so let's do one of those. So this is where we get to appreciate that we have an extra bishop in the opening. And not only that, it's a bishop that can like move like a knight, so it can change its color in some sense. So if I really wanted to, I could play c. Oh, c6 doesn't win material. I thought I was being clever. C6, he just says knight takes. Where's the fun in that? But yeah, maybe I can somehow obtain this hawk. Or maybe I get a king. I didn't think it was going to come down to that, but this attack is starting to get pretty serious. Yeah, and we have to find out where this is going. Also, I have to get a better move sound. Wait, what was my move sound earlier? The built-in move sound is what? Yeah, we can do that. As long as I don't have the bell on at the same time, that should be okay. I was considering bishop g6, but he's got pawn takes, and I'm not winning a rook. Not exactly. Let's go back. And this time, try to target this guy over here. Huh. That's unfortunate. Do I have anything here? So this moves like a knight or a rook. He's got nothing that moves diagonally. So if I like play queen e2, supposing he plays his hawk to e6, I could play bishop f5. He'd have to defend with his queen. Yeah, that could work. I'm not sure if it does, but it looks scary. Yes, this was alluding to earlier that, I mean, despite having a piece on c8, nothing's really defending the hawk. And sure, I did sack stuff, but I think the sack is actually pretty sound for multiple reasons. One, I could take the hawk, and I'm attacking the elephant, which can't go anywhere. Or two, I could play queen takes hawk. And I don't have a follow-up. So this actually looks strongest. Also, at some point I really need to move this elephant out. And yeah. Yeah, it can be useful sometimes if you're able to move your king off of its starting square. Right, it can go there. But that's not what I was worried about. Check. That was fun. I think I'm doing okay this game. Okay. Now is queen e5 checkmate? I think so. I'm not entirely sure. Oh, it is. Cool. Queen e5 checkmate. And there's no checkmate noise. And there's no u1 noise. Ugh, we have to remedy that, guys. That's important. Where's the win thing? Built-in sound.
You win.
Alright, cool. Alright, ooh. So we got, here, let me, it's important to take space in this game. It's basically the only thing I know about it. That and the whole Saxon, the F2 and F7 square are kind of fun. But that should not come as any big surprise to anyone. I want to play that, and I want to try to win c2 somehow. Let's be patient. Well, I keep forgetting. He can just move his bishop and then protect that. Here, let's bring out the hawk. Like this. Okay, so he's got a hawk supporting a hawk. There goes one of my knights. So I don't have any tricky shots against c2 anymore. That's okay. My pieces are still pretty active somehow. Now, one thing I'm not sure of, they say that when you castle, you can place a piece on either square, the either e8 or h8. This is what they say. I'm not sure that either the server or the client support that, but officially that's supposed to be the rule. Okay, let's just develop. They do say that a hawk might be worth about the same as a rook, and an elephant might be worth kind of sort of the same as a queen. I'm not sure if any of that makes sense. Probably doesn't, since I said it, but yeah, these new pieces are pretty powerful. So exchanging like hawk takes bishop would not be probably not be a good trade because a hawk moves like a bishop or a knight, and this moves just like a bishop. Oh, I did not see that coming. Let's take it. Okay. Let's take that. I'm forking the hawk and the elephant. Okay, let's take that. Yeah, white has done rapid development, so that's a good thing for white. See, now I've got my extra rook, or my elephant, just lined up with the king. That's a fun little thing to do, is if they haven't castled, just put the rook on this file and just see where things go. He's gonna castle soon, just FYI. Hang on, do we have something here? I honestly did not anticipate this, but you know. Let's be an opportunist and say that we're going to take advantage of it anyhow. I still can't play e5. What would it take for me to get to play e5? Okay, well, it looks like he's not going to get to castle. That's okay with me. Do I exchange? What's material like? I've got an elephant versus a knight. This can't be bad for me. Yeah, let's trade down. I really want to put my rook on d8, but this is actually the faster way to develop the elephant. Because now, if I plunk this on e6, I'm getting this pawn. Oh, maybe I take b2. Or, well, he's not going to keep his king there. Yeah, the king isn't staying there. I should just take this while it's still there. Rook d8 might have been a good alternative. Just gotta bring all the pieces into play. Oh man, I wish I had awesome tactics here. Get out of harm's way. It's fun how the pieces can chase each other around a little bit. Yeah, my point was actually that if he plays knight f3, I just go up another square, and if he plays knight g5, my knight goes, or my elephant goes who knows where. That was the idea. Let's see. All right, I should take the open file. Yeah, if people can figure out what are the admin commands for me to create like real accounts and set real passwords and stuff. Obviously, if I set your password, you need to change it to something more secure if you actually care about it. I'm not going to take some secret password. I'll probably just set them to like fruits and vegetables and other predictable things. And you guys have to change them at your discretion after I set it. Oh, look at this. I think I see something. Check. Yeah, that was not the correct rook to put on d1. The elephant moves like a knight, and it moves like a rook. So at this point, my knight's forking the king and the rook, as well as like guarding d3 and hitting the pawn and stuff. Oh, so wait, that's not mate. In other positions, I might have to do like knight take or elephant take c2. Let me just show that off. Oh wait, that doesn't mate though. So we'll just do the mate in
You
one.
win.
Yeah, we win, guys. We win. So, you know how in normal chess there's a piece that moves like a rook or a bishop and they call it a queen? This variant, there's the elephant that moves like a rook or a knight, and there's the hawk that moves like a bishop or a knight. Yeah, that was a good game. Wow, what a game. Oh, hey, look, we got another challenge. Here we go. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to try that program out. It's been a long time, so I don't remember all the details, but you're probably right. So this moves like a bishop or a knight. So bishop on c6 could maybe deal some damage, I'm not sure. But I think I can take the d5 square here. I'm starting to have second thoughts about whether I should have placed something at the same time. Placing a hawk there could have been fun. Okay, we're going places, guys. We're definitely going places. I don't know where we're going, but hopefully it involves a sack or two. Do I sack right away? I mean, I've got nothing supporting it. So, sacking would be kind of crazy. That's what I might do it anyway, but I don't know. Yeah, let's put the elephant back here. So I can always do a lateral transfer to get him out. Okay. Wow. I don't know if I want to put that out there. Do I just do F3? It feels so strange to play F3 here. What I really want to do is just bug house this up and sack for the fun of it, but I have the sense that it doesn't work so well. But yeah, if I don't bring out the hawk right now, I mean, where's the hawk gonna go? This is the best place for it. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's develop. Yeah. Let's play with fire. Here we go. Didn't expect that to happen. Okay. So I've got d4 and e5 already guarded by this hawk. I really wish I had another piece to just sack on f7 right away. That could be epic. Don't have any way to hunt down this piece, so maybe I just leave it off sides and ignore it. Let's castle before we lose that possibility. He says never play f3. Oh, that's no fun to never play it, though. Wait, no, his knight gets back if I do that. Let's just develop. Heck with the pawn. I'll take a tempo or two for it. Yeah. Anything's possible. Alright, so we got all the heavy pieces lined up in the center, ready to be taken. Unfortunately, we can only capture one at a time. So how do I continue development? See, do I do queen? Yeah, queen e2 seems reasonable here. At least until bad things happen. Which is probably very soon. I'm trying to find some synergy here. Oh. He's got a cheapo that he's trying to threaten. I should probably do something about that. Not that the cheapo worked, but just stopping it in its tracks makes this more fun. Yeah, if I move my hawk somewhere else, that could be hilarious. Obviously, this isn't what he had in mind. And I probably didn't need to do this either. It just looked like a fun thing to do. Okay. I'm not sure why that square. Oh! That queen is trapped. Ish. I did not realize that when I made my threat. Okay. So if I play A3, he's got Queen B6. It's not entirely trapped. Yeah, I've got a space advantage for sure. Maybe I just. Wait. That doesn't win material. Winning material's hard when you can't remember all the. You can't keep track of everything that's attacked. If I do A3, that might be my best play. He goes back. I could play knight A4. He goes to A6. I go knight C5. He goes queen B6. Still not seeing anything decisive. I think that's my best try, though. Yeah, there's a lot going on. This board is super crowded, because of the new pieces. It's really hard to keep track of everything that's here. And that's why I'm spending so much time moving and thinking. So my realization is this queen can't go to C7. So I'm pushing his pieces around pretty effectively here. Now, as for whether that benefits me, I'm not sure, but yeah, I see I'm at least able to force his queen to shuffle back and forth while I keep advancing. Didn't expect that because there's this counter, and now I've got even more pieces active. Okay, so he's taken my pawn. Dare I liquidate? I think I do. I don't think I have better than liquidating here. I do have b4. That knight is not going very far. Wow. What a position. Yeah. Elephant versus queen, indeed. Fun as it could be to play with the new pieces, that seems to be a tricky or a difficult trade to refuse. Okay, I'm gonna trade down and see where we go. At least I'm gonna make this trade. I don't think I'm gonna make the other trade. I think the other trade could be unwise. One thing I considered with all this is that he might end up doing what he did play, which keeps his pieces active, except for the knight on the rim. That knight on the rim is going to have some challenges getting developed. I'm attempting to cover the c4 square. We'll see how effective I actually am at that. Yeah, I guess more importantly, oh, that's a good developing move. I completely forgot he had that. So, how do I develop? Queen e2 develops, right? Queen e2, and now c4 is under my control. Yeah, that's the thing. That's what I'm worrying about here is actually I'm down 2.5 minutes with a 2 second increment. I can play that. It's going to involve me clicking more accurately. Oh. Or just winning material outright. That helps too. But yeah, that timer, that clock, is what had me concerned there. But, you know, now that I'm up material, who cares? I can convert this. Funny enough, this is not defending the knight. I guess also this hawk does defend the B pawn. Well, life's most difficult questions aren't going to get answered today. Just develop all the stuff. Throw the kitchen sink over here. Now, if only this D pawn weren't here, I could just put my bishop on. I just put this here, right? Oh, this is how I get around my D pawn. I found the way around it. Go me. So if this pawn weren't here, I could just move this around and like throw my rook to a3 to h3 and really get this attack started. But you know, none of that's necessary in this position. Oh, check it out. Wait, that's not a trapped piece. I sure thought I trapped it. I was really close. I get partial credit for that, okay? Man, I thought I had it. For a second there, that looked really awesome. And then suddenly, not as awesome. The key for my attack here is remembering that this moves like a knight, so giving checkmates actually going to be really tricky. Okay. Oh, that's a hawk. That's not a bishop. I was ready to sack the knight and do hawk takes elephant. And while that could simplify things, it's probably not a simplification I want to make. Let's just get out of the way. Not hang stuff. Because hanging stuff is bad. Yeah, this should have been a lot easier. Making a big deal over nothing, because this is still pretty good. Yeah, that elephant, that's quite a menace. Actually, trading my queen for the elephant might help me just keep my sanity. Because I'd still be up a bishop and a knight. But you know, I have to be greedy, even though I'm in time pressure. Okay. This is what I've been looking at. I think it's a trap. I'm not entirely sure anymore. It's close. Oh, that's check. Gosh darn it. Okay. That sucks. We're back to an even game, guys. Stay tuned for my next blunder. Okay, is this a trap? Have I finally trapped the damn piece? Apparently so. Yeah, no. That's not working. See, I had that planned all along. A brilliant trap of his elephant. Oh my goodness.
You win.
That piece was difficult to take. GG. Holy moly. Okay. See, I only had to sack my hawk to get the elephant. Although I guess he could have gone back to c5 and I would have had to trade a knight, so it still would have been a material loss, but a moral victory. All right. Oh, hawk to e5 could have saved it. Well, we sure bluffed him. Okay. Oh man. I'm gonna try to take as much of the center as I can. 'Cause, you know, when you have two extra pieces, every square counts. All right, we got a Vienna, guys. If we know anything about the Vienna, we know that it's that oh shoot, Fabiano blames his losses on the Vienna. That's what we know. Okay, how do I manage to get d5 in without losing material? This is a question I should have contemplated before going into this line. But now that we're here, how do I do it? YOLO! Maybe. It could be a home run. I don't know. So my big plan, oh. My big plan was to play b4. It actually forces knight a4. Maybe I just do d5. I mean, as great as b4 looks, d5 might be even more appealing. 'Cause, well, no, because then I potentially hanging my B pawn. So B4 it is. I might not need to use my pieces this game. Wait, do I just take e4? Is that my best move? Or do I play this anyway? I think I have to just take. Well, this is anticlimactic. Well, after I take, he gets crazy development, so I should be careful. Taking looks unwise. I mean, I'm really afraid of just all this development that's going to happen after I take that. It's going to be a complete and total fiasco. But what else can I do? This is really awkward. If I play d5, he might play d4. And then maybe I have to take it then. What else can I play? Surely there's got to be something I can do. I like this pawn on b4. It's really good looking. Not sure if it's effective, but it looks good. I think I just have to get castled as soon as possible and get out of here. That any material grabbing I do is worse than the material grabbing I do in normal chess. Yeah, let's just get out of here. I have a space advantage, I can enjoy that. Man, turning down that material. It's not something I do often. Okay. Defend the bishop. Still have a hawk to place. I think I'm just going to end up winning the e-pawn. I have to be careful because I can't just play g6. If g6, he has hawk g or a hawk h6. Hawk practically goes mate by itself. Slight overstatement, but it's pretty powerful. But how else do I evict this guy? I guess I have to deploy my own hawk against it. That's no fun. I want something sharper and more exciting than that. But, yeah, here we go. Found a way to evict it, but I was hoping for something more exciting. Yeah. I mean, if you've seen me play on Lee Chess, you know, I am keen for grabbing material. I definitely have an affinity for all kinds of dubious stuff. All right. So, we're all said and done here. I've got some center control. A knight on the rim is dim. And my king is safe, and I might actually start attacking now. Starting with this. Okay. I don't have any mate. Bummer. And I don't have my hawk either. My hawk could be so fun here. Just imagine all the fun that could be had. That's not there. Oh man, it's hard to believe this, but it seems my best attacking move is just retreating. Keeping control of the center squares. That's really lame, but I think that's accurate. Yeah, it's really easy to hang a piece here and not even know it. Okay. So, just gotta complete that development. Oh, I forgot. He has that possibility. Let's reinforce that. I should have dropped my queen back so I could play a5 rather than c5. Regardless, that knight isn't going very far. Nor, well, I mean, this is eventually going to get out. But I can try to delay development of that as well. Okay, that's cool. I'm being greedy. I should have just taken. Wait, no, that doesn't win heavy material because it's defended. But no, I definitely saw this in advance. I kind of anticipated some of that. Just because it's really tempting to want to move that knight. So I'm constantly vigilant, looking for can he move this somewhere and tear my position apart. So I was looking out for that possibility before it happened. Let's see. Take one of those. Do I play bishop c5? Do I just. Oh, here we go. Develop another piece. Man, if I could get. If I had my hawk, I could place it there, and we'd have four knights in a row. They'd be the four horsemen. Okay, I'll take one of those. Sure. Why not? Okay, and now we have a chess game on our hands. Imagine that. Yep. Yeah. Oops, I dropped my a pawn. I sure hope he doesn't take it. Okay. But no, the serious point is that I really want to develop this. Let's develop this too. Oh no, he took my a pawn. Whatever will I do?
You win.
Hooray! I'm a winner. Okay. Got a challenge here, guys. So yeah. Okay. Yeah, I guess you're right. Rook takes bishop isn't terrible there. I got kind of lazy toward the end. In case it wasn't clear. See, do I take that? Yeah, let's take. Wait. How good and or bad could this get? Okay, so we're looking at a Nimzowitsch, not looking at a I can't even remember the name of it. Not looking at the center counter or Scandinavian. So, an important distinction there is that if I hit the queen, he can actually take. Okay, so we just take a space advantage, I suppose. As long as I don't let some stupid sack happen that wins heavy material, I should be fine. All right, here we go. I played F3. They say never play F3. I've played it. Truly, I have tempted the CR1 chess fates to do their worst. Okay, so got one piece developed. This is crumbling faster than I hoped. I'm gonna get all kinds of pinned for doing this, but what can you do? Yeah, gotta do this. Thankfully, oh wow. This is gonna get exciting. This is gonna get really sharp. Oh, yeah, you're right. So I played F3, you played F6, so it all balances out. So, hopefully the fates have completely forgotten about my F3 move. Okay. What do I do? Oh, it does attack multiple things. That's a really strong attacking move. Okay. I'm kind of at a loss to address it. That's pretty amazing. Maybe I just drop the d pawn and say, forget it. Let's give that a try. I'm not just dropping the d pawn either. This is a gambit of at least two pawns, possibly with me sacking on f8 to follow. So that's check. So I got all my pieces out. I only had to lose my entire center to do it. That said, maybe I've got some compensation. So, how do I play? Man, if that knight weren't here, this would be a slam dunk. there be? I mean, I just play like Elephant F3 and that'd be game ish. As it stands, things are not so simple. Okay, how do I develop? He's got d4 under his domain. I might have to play bishop b5, even though I really don't want to. What else am I gonna play though? Well, this opens up a fun tactical possibility. If I had another tempo, oh, would I be moving pieces to squares? There's my tempo. Guys, I hope you're paying attention, because I'm about to play a move that's either really good or really bad. If it's really bad, I hope you're not paying attention. Bishop A7. So, the knight's pinned, right? Knight's pinned, knight can't take the bishop. The knight that's pinned is not protecting the hawk. And so I'm able to attack the elephant and the hawk on the same turn with that crazy maneuver. Now the knight is still pinned, so this hawk I'm collecting for the price of two bishops. Plus I've got some attacking chances here. So now I play elephant e6, threatening the queen, threatening mate in one. Do I have better? I could sack my rook to win the queen. This is crazy. So many possibilities. Oh, I could just play elephant f7. Holy crap, that's strong. That wins at least a rook. Yeah, I don't think I can beat that. Can I? Elephant e6, knight f6, queen h5, knight takes queen. Oh, this isn't mate. Oh, come on. Why don't I get the checkmate? Alright, so, yeah, I think elephant f7 is probably the best white can do there. I think a hawk is probably worth about the same as a rook. Maybe a bit more, I don't know. I think an elephant and a queen are kind of similar. Not entirely sure. Sirwan's got some theories too. He's talked about it in greater detail. Okay, now if I've calculated correctly, the fact that he's avoided this trade of a elephant for a queen, means I have this
You
possibility.
win.
Yeah. I calculated correctly, guys. Go me. So yeah, just to refresh you guys, you can go to that link that I typed in earlier. Let me see if I can scroll up and find it. Where is that link? Where is it? It's not Relay Chess. Nope. It's not RelayChess.mu.com. Okay, let me see if I could find it this way. There it is. Let me drop that here one more time. So if you go to that link, it'll link you to the website where you can pick up the interface. And once you have that interface, you can type in the URL of my server and connect to it and play this game. If anybody ever helps me figure out how to do the admin commands and stuff, that'd be great. In the meantime, everybody's just playing using guest accounts, which is also great. And at some point, I might actually be able to watch people play a game instead of playing a game myself. And it can be maybe more liberating to comment when I'm not forced to calculate all this stuff while playing. Let's see. I wanted to play the Budapest, but that seems kind of unwise, doesn't it? Screw it. We're gonna go toward this. It might fail horribly. But we're gonna try. Okay. Here we go. Budapest Gambit. Probably refuted, but we're gonna see if I can somehow pull this out. It could be fun, that's for sure. Okay. I think I'm okay here already. So, just take d4. And there's not a whole lot going on anymore. So now we've transposed into some kind of reversed Scandinavian thing where white's up a tempo, I guess. I guess white's always up a tempo when you get a reversed opening, but it's kind of axiomatic. Do I put the hawk on f8? Or do I just block? Well, this hawk's not going anywhere else, so. Okay, I've got all my knights out. This board is kind of cramped. Let's see. Let's get out of this. I have to get all my other knights off the back row. So, yeah, if you think that one knight is a tricky piece, this game gives you four knights to play with. So, it's quadruple the confusion. The amazing aspect of this is that with his elephant here and his hawk there, nothing other than the queen is protecting c2. So that allows me to do some shenanigans, which ordinarily you would not see. Okay, I've completely lost track of where we're going here. Got bishop g5, which probably hangs too much stuff. Yeah, definitely hangs too much. I've got. I don't want to do that, but it's probably my best move. Stuff I can do with tempo still. Now, does elephant d6 gain me even more tempi? It's hard to imagine that it doesn't. Actually, wait, the queen's the only thing defending c2, and I can displace that defender right away. Like so. So, yeah, this is just kind of winning on the spot, which is pretty cool. Yeah, hawk to g6 looked good, but then I found this move, which is just like instantly winning. So, this move's kind of better. Right. So that's the best he can do. is make that exchange. If he played his knight to d4, I just take it and then fork him. So it's not White's greatest hour, that's for sure. Although I only won whatever that exchange is worth. So it's not the biggest exchange ever. Let's see if I can do something about his hawk. Yeah, queen for elephant might be okay in hindsight. So maybe hawk g6 is the way to go. I got greedy, in other words. And I'm not sure if that greed was a bad thing. Because I don't know how much the pieces are worth. Bam! There we go. So I kind of overstated the value of elephant d6, but this is pretty good. We're not going to overstate it this time. It's just pretty good. Okay, we're going to castle. And yeah, now I'm just up a queen for an elephant, whatever that's worth, and just a normal exchange. Let's see if we can pin the knight. Probably not, because he's probably paying attention. Even so, pinning the knight's not the end of the world. I'm just trying to trade down and get into an end game. Also, I might want to just put the bishop on b7 instead of pinning it. Although the pin has some appeal because then there's discoveries that follow as soon as the king moves somewhere and fun stuff. Okay, there we go. So if I check, king moves, queen takes, yeah. King goes to e1, unfortunately, otherwise I might have stuff, but I don't. Okay, he played a good defensive move. Had he gone to d1, bishop a6, king there. Oh, queen check. He could have knight to d2, and I thought he'd be forced to play elephant d2 and get pinned, which would be unfortunate for him. But no, he played a good defensive move. Obviously intending going to d4 next. So let's take away his advanced square there. Oh shoot, I was considering e5 instead. e5 is superior. Well, let's get through this first. e5 is superior because if he does tactics, I have better responses. Basically, is the gist of it. Plus e5 gives me the option of playing bishop f5. So this is good for slower stuff, but e5 would have been faster. This just gives me good long-term pressure, which is an easy, practical decision to make. It's fun remembering how the pieces move, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, wait. Okay, he actually came up with something there. I'm impressed. I thought I had him, like, pinned to the wall with that last move. He found, like, the only move that defends d2 without hanging the elephant. I thought I had this, guys. I'm so disappointed. Much wow. Alright, so if I take, I just sack both exchanges back, we get an end game where I'm up two pawns. It's not what I was going for. I guess this is my best way to go. Intending Bishop D3. Yeah, it's fun remembering how the pieces move. How boring would it be if I could remember all these things? So I actually do have to stand by that statement, but it takes on a different tone. You know, when you're on the receiving end of it, doesn't feel so clever. So, yeah, the fun thing about the elephant is like you can move diagonally one space from it and you're safe there. But pretty much anywhere else, it sucks. You don't want to be anywhere near that. That's not what I thought was going to happen. I thought he was going to play F3. The reason why is because I can kind of force that to move. Although I'm being retarded here. Yeah, no. Both last turn and this turn, he had just elephant takes bishop, which we both either missed or misevaluated. But I lucked out. All right, so that elephant makes it really difficult for me to invade. So we're just gonna go around this side of the board, start taking things, and let the circle of life walk its course. Oops, he didn't take that, so just exchange there. Okay. Now have I calculated correctly that it's not a hawk, that's an elephant. I should be winning it. Yeah, that would have been a nice move, unless I'm missing something. That's possible, I might still have something crazy like playing F5 followed by playing B5, and maybe I'm still
You
matings.
win.
Maybe he does get trapped there somehow, I'm not sure. So maybe he actually did a calculate that accurately. Back here-ish. Yeah, maybe this was forced because if he does take that, maybe I just play F5. Oh, we just goes back to E2. Okay, so yeah, he's fine. In fact, yeah, you could always go back to C4 and then C2 too. So, how about that? Yeah. So, that's Sierra Wan Chess in a nutshell. What a mess. Yeah, Sierra Wan Chess, invented by Grandmaster and one of the world's best chess players, Yasser Sierra Wan, along with his friend, presumably strong chess player, although I haven't met him. Don't know much about him, Bruce Harper. I guess if people are interested in more of this, let me know. We could do some more of this sometime. be fun to see people take an interest in the variant. Although it seems that even during this stream, during the inaugural stream, it seems like people have tuned out. And or they just, there isn't much to say, or there's just too much to say and not enough time in which to say it. But yeah, I think it's a great variant. That's my opinion. Everybody's entitled to their own opinion, but anywho, we got the server up and running, the client, the Winboard 4.5TM client works, server works. I still don't know how to make accounts, though I'll try to figure it out. Maybe I should try to make some sort of leaderboard or something, I don't know. Although this has its own like built-in leaderboard if I understand right. Like if I type in rank. Yeah, nobody's got ratings, but if people did have ratings, this would show the leaderboard. So, yeah, there's a barrier for learning the game for sure. Also, a barrier for even connecting to the darn server. So, I don't know. I have to give it some thought. Maybe there's a better way to do this. Maybe it just needs more flash or more sound effects or something. Maybe it needs a better interface so you know how to drop the pieces onto the board. There's a lot of possibilities. But yeah, if people are interested, we could do more of this sometime. So, hope you enjoyed. And I guess so, next time we end up doing chess or something of this nature, maybe I'll give this one more go. Or maybe I'll try some of the engine stuff I've been doing too, and then maybe come back to this. I suppose if I look more into like opening theory and endgame theory and stuff, maybe that's where this gets more interesting. There's a lot of possibilities. I'm not sure where to take it. If people know a lot about this, I guess some guidance or advice as to like what would be most interesting to do next. It could be fun. I know people have been crying for it to be added to Lee Chess, but even here there hasn't seemed to be much interest in it. And while people have also asked for there to be an engine for it, what's the point of making the damn engine if nobody's gonna play the game anyhow? I don't know. Yeah, it's a great game. I just don't know, like, if it's gonna be popular or not. Occasionally, I mean, I don't want to say that I'm not going to ever play it ever again, because that'd be crazy, but yeah, I think on occasion I will try to just bump this variant and see if I can get it to become more popular. Not gonna give up on it by any means, but I'm not sure if my efforts alone are going to be enough to make any of a difference, so time will tell. Yeah, we do need the relay engine too. I have put in quite a bit of effort trying to get that working, and yeah, maybe I should go back and do a coding stream of that sometime. That could be fun. Oh, cool. Yeah, I really don't mean to pressure at all. And that's kind of like why with that server I've been pushing back a little bit on scope as to like what does it really need for people to take interest in it? I think we got some pretty solid things working there. I think people will really appreciate the engine, so I'll put in some more effort trying to get that going. It can be fun to do a coding stream of that again. Maybe this time I have a better idea what I'm doing. We'll see. Anyhow, yep, that's Sierra One Chess. Hope people enjoyed it. Looking forward to ideas, comments, suggestions, feedback of some sort. And yeah, hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you next time.